In this video, I'll walk through an example of Dalton's law of partial pressures. A sample of ammonia gas, NH3, is completely decomposed to nitrogen and hydrogen gases over heated iron wool. If the total pressure is 900 millimeters mercury, calculate the partial pressures of the nitrogen and the hydrogen gases, N2 and H2. I really like this example because it seemingly gives you very little, but that gives us a chance to discuss this Dalton's law of partial pressures. First, let's remember the ideal gas equation. That is PV equals nRT. Well, just solving for pressure, the P, you get P equals nRT divided by the volume. Okay, so that is the formula to find the pressure of a gas. Notice in this formula, nothing has to do with the mass of the gas or its molar mass or anything, but it does have to do with the number of moles, N, number of moles. So therefore, the Dalton's law of partial pressures, we don't have to be concerned with a different mass of gas or its molar mass. All we have to be concerned with is the number of moles. Now naturally, 10 grams of hydrogen gas is different from 10 grams of nitrogen gas, but ultimately we are concerned with the number of moles. We would convert that to the number of moles. And what I'm saying there is one gas acts the same as another gas. The same number of moles of one gas acts the same as the same number of moles as another gas. So here's what I'm getting at. The partial pressures equals the total pressure. So P sub T is the total pressure, and that equals the partial pressure of one gas plus the partial pressure of another gas plus the partial pressure of another gas, and so on. In our example, we only have two gases, so it would just be P sub A and P sub B. Then you could do some rearranging here. You could say P sub A and P sub B and rewrite this equation and then add those up. But in the end, I'll kind of jump to the conclusion here to show that the total pressure in a system or a mixture of gases equals the RT over V, right? Because the volume of the mixture of gases, the temperature that it's at which it is, and the constant R, and then multiplied by the sum of the number of moles. So N sub A plus N sub B plus N sub C plus so on, if you have more than one gas. So all we're looking at is a comparison of a number of moles. So what I'm saying is it's the ratio of moles that we're going to use to find the individual partial pressures. And we'll just sum up the partial pressures to get the total pressure. So I just wanted to talk about that concept of the partial pressures, because a lot of problems will just give you the numbers and you plug them in, and that's great. That's good to be able to use the formula, but we want to understand what this partial pressure means. So we're just going to look at the number of moles. So let's talk about what is happening. We have to understand what is happening here from the NH3. The NH3 is being decomposed into a nitrogen gas and a hydrogen gas. Now we have to balance this equation. So I'm going to throw some numbers in there. Let's put a 2 in front of the NH3. And so we've got two nitrogens on the left and two nitrogens on the right. That looks good. But now we have six hydrogens on the left. So we need to multiply this one by a 3. So 3 times 2 is a 6 hydrogens on the right. So now we're looking good. This equation is balanced. And now we look at this and say, hey, we have a ratio. We have 1 mole of N2 gas for every 3 moles of H2 gas. Okay, even if we don't know how many moles we have, we have this ratio of 1 to 3. And so, in my opinion, the easiest way to look at this is to say we have 4 total moles. 4 moles total. right? 1 to 3. Even if we don't have 4 moles, it's a four units total. 1 to 3 ratio. You're just adding the numerator and the denominator. And if you had more gases than just the two, then you would add up all of the ratio of all of those. 4 moles total, or I can say 4 units total. And we know what is contributing to the pressure is just the number of moles. Of course, you have the temperature and the volume play a role as well, but we're not given that. So we can just say we have these 4 units. So what we're going to do is we're going to divide the 900 divided by the 4 units. And that equals 225 millimeters of mercury for every unit. Well, one of those units is given to nitrogen. So in the end, we'll say that the nitrogen has 225 millimeters of mercury. So that is for the nitrogen gas. That's the partial pressure of nitrogen. We have to multiply by 3 to get the hydrogen. So 225 times 3, or that equals 675 millimeters of mercury for the hydrogen, the H2 gas. So I'll circle those answers. And I hope I impressed enough on you that it is the number of moles that we're concerned with. So if you're given grams, convert it to moles right away. And of course, this other stuff will play a role. The temperature and the volume certainly play a role if you're given that as well. But even if you're not, you can calculate the partial pressures given just the information where you can find the ratio of moles of one gas to the other. If you found this video helpful, consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.